feels good to see the world getting loose. Feels good to see the world getting loose.
I don't know about you, Sack Noel.
I don't know about you, Phenom.
I don't know about you,
White Shadow.
I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good.
I'm 2+2, I'm for sure. You down, I'm down, baby, let's go. You stop, you drop, baby, then roll. You twerk, you pop, booty so swole. I'd hate me too if I were you. And when it comes to billions, I'll take two. It's only one life, you don't get two. So live life, don't let it live you.
I got a pocket full of $100 bills. Put on a jacket, cause these diamonds give you chills. 2 shots are running, 2 out, I'm stunning tonight. Track of keys. Ooh, up to something. Ooh, yeah, I love it. All right. Over.
Yeah, yeah. I'm drinking out the bottle.
Get loose.
Hanging with supermodels.
Get loose.
Feel like I hit the lotto.
I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good.
But I feel good.
I'm 1+1, I'm too strong. If you ain't about money, then get gone. I wanna wild out all night long. You wanna ride out, then get on. I'd hate me too if I were you. And when it comes to billions, I'll take 2. It's only one life, you don't get 2. So live life, don't let it live you.
I got a pocket full of $100 bills. Put on a jacket, cause these diamonds give you chills. 2 shots are running, 2 out, I'm starting tonight.
About you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good. I don't know about you, but I feel good.
I need you all night. Come on, dance with me.
I'm levitating. You can fly away with me tonight. You can fly away with me tonight. Baby, let me take you for a ride. We'll be right back.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Say they all add up.
Thank you, Patrick, for putting together that slideshow. Good evening to all of our parents. It's time to be quiet now. To all of our parents, administrators, special guests from the SSIA executive and former VP of Centennial, Mr. Giulioni, coaches, and most importantly, our Centennial Charger student athletes. Welcome to Sports Awards 2022. My name is Jesse Heron, and it is my pleasure to be your co-MC for tonight's awards presentation, along with Miss Charger Chuckle herself, Valerie Rosenoff.
that wasn't embarrassing at all. All right. So we're so happy to be back in person and all together to celebrate. I'm especially happy to be back coaching. I love headaches and I love bad tan lines.
Tonight is a special time for all our Charger athletes, as they will be honored for representing Centennial in a wide variety of individual and team events during our 2021-2022 interscholastic season. To be selected as a member of a Charger team is a terrific accomplishment in itself. And then to go on and represent Centennial in both the SSIAA and RSEQ leagues is definitely a privilege. Tonight, all of our athletes will be honored by being called up on stage. Then, the winners of the MIP and MVP team awards will be announced. We ask that everyone remain respectful and not talk and yell out while names are being called. When your team is called up on stage, please come up using the staircase in front of me or on the side. Line up in front of the tables and then leave using the stairs at the other end of the stage. All senior MVP winners must go to the CAF with the trophy to get a picture taken. We ask that everyone please hold their applause until the entire team has come up on stage. We also ask that you please make sure all cell phones are put on silent. So, without further ado, let's start with our first team to be recognized tonight, golf, coached by Ms. Dunn and Mr. G. So everyone that played golf, you come up on stage. This year's Charger team had only senior golfers placing third at the SSIAA tournament. We would like to take the opportunity to thank all parents for their time and dedication to this team. Without your support on the tournament day, we would not be able to have golf athletes at Centennial. The most improved player goes to Nathan Valente. MVP, Zach Rahal. Okay, congratulations. Bantam Girls Field Hockey, coached by Ms. Dunn and Ms. Chartrand. Even though it was the first field hockey experience for all of the girls, they were all able to learn and enjoy their day. They came prepared, and even though they weren't 100% certain of what they were doing, by the end of the day, everyone had adapted and played well. Please stop talking. I can hear you. Stop. The improvement noted by all the girls in one day was incredible. The girls cheered. There's a lot. The girls cheered on their teams the whole day, and even though they fell short of winning the banner, the future looks bright. Thank you to our senior coaches, Megan Francard, Hannah Chaban, Sarah Yamasaki, and Megan Butler. The team's co-most valuable players of the grade 7 team are Bianca Delier and Luna Arcuri. Co-MVPs for the grade 8 team are Stella D'Alessio and Amber Picado.
You can go, yeah. Congrats. Thank you. All right. So, junior girls field hockey coached by Mr. Martin and Miss Heron. Come on down. Junior girls field hockey. Coming off COVID years without sports, the girls were happy to be back into the swing of things and on the field with team sports. For many of our players, this was a brand new and challenging sport with the darn lefty sticks. However, they developed and picked up the necessary skills quickly. The MIP for the junior girls field hockey is Anaïs Samanez-Denis. MVP, Kilia Sauvageau. Thank you, congratulations. Next, I'd like to welcome senior girls field hockey, coached by Jesse Heron and Mr. Martin. The senior girls field hockey team had a great short season. They worked together and won a fair share of games. Good luck to all the senior girls graduating this year. The co-MVPs are Megan Butler and Megan Francaire. Congratulations.
Cross country, coached by Mr. Dunn and Mr. G. This year's cross country team consisted of 45 athletes. We don't have to walk and talk, guys. It's okay. Quiet. These runners were motivated and a pleasure to work with. Our Bantam girls and boys teams competed for the SSIA banners, where our girls finished a respectable second place and the Bantam boys finished in first place, winning the SSIA banner. The junior and senior teams competed well, bringing in second and third place wins overall. Congratulations to all runners who went on to compete at the regional level. Our future looks bright having such a young team. Looking forward to next season. Good luck to all our grads. We have three MVP winners. First one, Liam Illick. Second MVP, Daniel Walsh. And finally, Caitlin Hewitt.
Good job, guys. You can leave. Go.
Bantam Boys, Grade 7 Soccer, coached by Mr. Dobbs. What a season! After a few weeks of intense training, we had our one-day tournament here at Centennial. It was a beautiful day for soccer, and our teams did not disappoint. We knew going into the tournament it would be difficult as the entire team was Grade 7. But you held your own and even showed the grade 8 team that you could play with the big boys, drawing a 2-2 tie against them and finishing third in the standings. Special thank you to our student coaches, Damian, Jeff, and Kimmy. Without your help, it would not have been possible to have two Bantam teams. Looking forward to seeing everyone back on the field come September. Most improved player goes to Diego Asensio Galarte. And the MVP goes to Anthony Sorrell. Thank you. Bantam Boys Grade 8 team, coached by Mr. Thanopoulos and Mr. Sumas. In making it to the finals, the Grade 8 team put on a skillful display. The game consisted of jaw-dropping highlights and a riveting comeback. With a wild cat in nets, a flanks at defense, pure speed on the wings and at midfield, and absolute chargers at the forward lines, the victory was well deserved. Congratulations to all of the boys. Most improved player goes to Nathan Chin. Most valuable player, Nathan Mack. Senior boys soccer, burgundy and gold, coached by Ms. Rosenoff and Mr. Martin. Although the season consisted of a one-day tournament, it was a great way to kick off sports being back here at CRHS. Okay guys, please be quiet. Once everyone comes up on the stage, then you can cheer and clap, okay? But even little whispering, we hear everything, so please stop. Although the season consisted of a one-day tournament, it was a great way to kick off sports being back here at CRHS. These senior boys had to suffer through extreme cold temperatures throughout their entire tournament. Despite the cold weather, the Burgundy went undefeated in the round-robin stage. After winning both their games, the boys faced Heritage in the final. We went down 2-0 and at the beginning of the game, but the boys fought hard to try and make a comeback. Unfortunately, we were not able to win the finals, but the team played great and never gave up. Great job on finishing second place in the tournament. Co-MVPs for the Burgundy team, Dante Troji and Anastasios Kritis. Co-MVPs of the gold team, Hayden Gardner and Sebastian Martinez de Vila. Thank you. Curling, coached by Mr. Filion and Mr. Allen. This year saw a mix of returning and new curlers to the CRHS curling team. Even though our season was cut short by the pandemic, CRHS was admirably represented by curlers from all grade levels. We look forward to competing in a full season again next year. A special farewell to Caitlin and Keo Hewitt, our graduating curlers who delivered a championship banner to CRHS in every year they competed. Thank you for your leadership and dedication. The MIP goes to Thomas Gammon. MVP, Caitlin Hewitt.
Thank you. Bantam Girls Basketball, coached by Miss Mimo and Miss Logis Warren. Girls, you don't need to talk to get upstage. The Centennial Bantam Girls Basketball team did an exceptional job this year. They finished first in the SSIA League and fought hard in the RSEQ division. This year has not been easy, but the team persevered through one of the toughest seasons with all its uncertainties. We are proud of the growth we saw this season and looking forward to seeing their progression in the basketball program. The MIP goes to Grace Angers. MVP, Jordan McGurk. Okay. Thank you. Bantam Boys Grade 7 Basketball, coached by Mr. Dobbs. Sadiqa. Thank you. This group of talented grade 7 boys already had everyone talking and looking at the future of Centennial basketball. After finishing 8-0 in the Atom RSEQ regular season and outscoring their opponents 539-135, the team easily went on to win the RSEQ regional banner. In SSIAA, despite being a grade 7 team, this group of young men weren't just competitive. They showed everyone their skills and desire to excel and went on to finish second overall in SSIAA. The drive that many of these teammates already have will definitely help them grow as these boys continue to develop. We are looking forward to what the future brings for this group of basketball players. The MIP goes to Emery Hippolyte. MVP, Frederick Mansala. Thank you. Bantam Boys Basketball, Grade 7 and 8 team. Coached by Mr. Thanopoulos. If you talk between every team, it's gonna take a lot more time, please. There is tremendous potential in Centennial's young basketball players. The grade 7-8 developmental team showed up to every game fighting till the end and playing their hearts out. Proud to represent their school and committed to stand up for their teammates. Big wins, some losses, all in all, every game. The MIP goes to Adrian Saint-Germain. MVP, Jaden Beckles. Thank you. Bantam Boys Basketball Grade 8 team, coached by Mr. Chesney. It was a welcomed relief to not only hear basketballs dribbling again in the gyms at Centennial, but to see so many players try out for Bantam Basketball. As a result, we had the pleasure of watching three Bantam Boys teams take to the court and represent the Chargers this season. This year, the Sec 2 boys competed in both RSEQ and SSIAA and showed great toughness despite playing against some stronger opponents. That said, the season was a success as the boys learned how to communicate as teammates and better channel their emotion and energy on the court. This resiliency was on display during two spirited second half comebacks and three very close games against a talented Sec 1 team. We are incredibly proud of the strides these boys took this season and look forward to seeing them grow even further physically and metaphorically next year. The MIP goes to Riaz Zuberi. MVP, Cameron Beals. Thank you. Boys, that way. That way, like everyone else has been doing this whole time. Junior girls basketball team. And senior girls basketball team. So both senior and junior girls basketball. Coached by Miss Heron and myself. For the junior girls, although there were only a few games played in the SSIA, the girls were able to gain some experience and develop not only their individual skills, but their team play as well. Keep working hard. Thank you to Alex Bergeron for all your help. For the senior girls basketball team, with a tough loss in the SSIA finals, the girls headed to the RSCQ regionals, hoping to win another medal. Playing for the bronze, they found themselves down by 10 with 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter, and they fought their way back to win by one. In what was a very long season, this team continued to put in the work, and in the end, it paid off, being SSIA silver medal finalists and RSCQ regional bronze medal winners. They should be proud of their accomplishments. Congratulations and good luck to the graduating seniors. You will be missed. For junior girls basketball, the co-MIPs are Maeve Tom and Ariadne Leonidaki. For senior girls basketball, we have co-MVPs, Alina Chopra and Megan Butler. Thank you. I'll read this one. Junior boys basketball, coached by Mr. Martin. There was no lack of spirit in these boys and no quit as they came back from an 11-point deficit in their SSIAA semifinals and made a game of it with Heritage leading by one after three quarters. But this team was about more than just wins and losses. They were about the smiley face emoji. Keep on playing for the love of the game and improvements will come. We will see you on the courts next year. Congrats, boys. MIP, Ashton Enfield. MVP, Caden Dewey Hall. Thank you. Stay me.
You should give me a water.
All right, senior boys basketball, coached by Mr. Lange and Mr. Rogers. Quiet, please. COVID made for a challenging schedule with a big unplanned break in the middle. But unlike 2020-2021, we had a season, and that is all that really matters. The senior boys had a successful season, going 11-6 and narrowly missing out on the RSEQ regionals, while finishing second during the regular SSIA season and third in the SSIA playoffs. The team was dominated by secondary four students, so next year's team will be very strong and we expect great things from this group. Thanks to our three graduating seniors, Loic, Zach, and Nathan. All right. Your enthusiasm and love of the game were contagious. Good luck on the court, in the classroom, and in life as you move on from Centennial. You are always welcome in our gyms. Congratulations to this excellent team on a fine season. You represented Centennial with exceptional class and committed and were an absolute joy to coach. We can't wait for the next year to get started. MIP, Akarsh Saini. MVP, Kimmy Fontaine. Thank you. Senior boys hockey, coached by Miss Mimo, Daniel Rosenoff, and Bobby Lee. So some of the basketball players could stay, thank you. After a long season of uncertainty, losing our practice space and using solely determination and spirit, this team of hockey players pulled through to win the silver medal in regionals. Congrats to our Sec 5 boys on coming back for last year as a Charger hockey player, and good luck next year. MIP, Damian Mack. MVP, Dante Troji. Thank you.
Bantam Badminton, coached by Ms. Ron and Mr. Gio Kindizi. What a wonderful badminton season. We are shocked when over 100 students came out to tryouts in October. We started off the season by adding many new grade 7 students to the team and welcomed back our returning players. We had many morning practices and 3 after school tournaments, but we came out on top. In the SSIAA, the Bantam teams won the mixed and doubles banner. We are already looking forward to next year. We are very proud of you all. If there is one amazing thing that has happened this year, is your dedication in all practices. Keep up the good work. We have 4 MVPs. Let's start with 2. Co-MVP Tanya Dimitrov and Caitlin Leung. Other MVPs, Liam Illick and Nicholas Dobbs. Congratulations. Get off. Junior Badminton, this was an amazing team to watch on the court. Some of our boys' matches would literally stop parents from other schools to sit down and watch exciting rallies going. We are proud to see the strong caliber in this team and can't wait to see the matches next year at the senior level. At the SSIAA, we won both boys' doubles and girls' double banner. Congratulations to this amazing group of Charger athletes. It's junior badminton, right? No one else? MVP, Roxanne Grignot and Zoe McClellan. More MVP awards, Alexi Tam and Clayton Chung. Good job. Senior badminton, boys and girls. This team had a hard time making it to those early morning practices. Struggling throughout our season, we still had good results and winning the doubles game at the girls' level. We wish the best of luck to our graduating students. Most improved, Vagilia Papagiannis. Thank you. Bantam Girls Volleyball, coached by Mrs. Dunn and Ms. Chartrand. This year, Centennial was able to field two Bantam Girl Volleyball teams. They played in a shortened SSIA season of three tournaments and finished second and fourth, respectively, after regular season play. Unfortunately, both teams lost their semifinals in the playoffs in the third set. The girls have a lot of energy and are very dedicated group, spending many lunch hours working on their serves to improve their skill. We are very proud of this group and look forward to seeing what their potential brings in our volleyball program in the years to come. Gold team, most improved player goes to Isabella Montescleros. MVP, Ella Morno. Burgundy team MIP goes to Sophia Semetic. MVP, Sadiqa Bansal. Bantam Boys Volleyball Gold Team, coached by Mr. Dan Kessler. We grew so much together as a team, and you boys really exemplified what a team really is. Always playing hard and cheering on your teammates from the bench was an amazing thing to see. You guys had a never quit attitude that helped us become a great success. That attitude helped give us the team nickname of the Comeback Kings, because even when we were down, we never panicked and always managed to get back into the game. We came back so many times that Coach Dan lost count and lost his voice on many occasions. Your playing style also aged him beyond his years. This team was so fun to coach, they will not be forgotten. Good luck to those going up to grade 9 next year, and I look forward to coaching all of those returning players next year. Have a great end to your school year, and have an amazing summer. Co-MIPs go to Carter Wise and Dustin Cambridge. Good job. Bantam Boys Volleyball Burgundy Team, coached by Mr. Dobbs. From the beginning, this season was about developing our team volleyball skills, as no one had a chance to play volleyball for the past 2 years. As we developed our individual skills, our team play continued to improve as well. And it just so happened that along the way of becoming a volleyball team, we captured the banner. In the last tournament, all our hard work in our morning practices paid off. After beating SLI in the semis, we went on to play against the other Centennial team in the finals, where we won the SSIA banner. Congratulations to both Bantam Boys volleyball teams. We practiced together, we played together. The banner was awarded to one team, but we are one team. The banner belongs to all of us. Go Chargers. Co-MIPs, V. Borsani. Nicholas Allen Drakos. Congratulations. Junior girls volleyball coached by Mr. Martin. So many kids came out in waves, 60 girls interested in being a Charger in this return to play season. We narrowed it down to 12 keen kids who represented Centennial proudly. After a very competitive year in D3 volleyball, the girls separated themselves from their SSIA counterparts, playing volleyball the way it's meant to be played. The way we finish will inspire them for years to come. The most improved player goes to Chloe Walsh. The MVP, Benny DeJunga. Junior boys volleyball, also coached by Mr. Martin. Potential. Looking forward to seeing the 2022-23 version of this team. The boys won the SSIA regular season but lost in the playoffs. They had a berth in the D3 regionals but fell short, which will hopefully inspire them for next season. The most improved player goes to Kimmy Fontaine. MVP, Alexi Tam. Senior girls volleyball, coached again by Mr. Martin. Twelve girls heading off to CJEP finished off their high school careers with a solid season, playing with friends and making memories. Perhaps. We finished off a little below where we wanted to in the standings, but our love of the game kept us improving throughout the year. I wish all of these kids continued success, and hopefully they will find leagues to play in years to come. The most improved player goes to Megan Francard. The most valuable player goes to Adelia Mosley. Senior boys volleyball coached by Alex Bergeron. Congratulations to the Sec 5 senior boys volleyball team. What an impressive season it has been. Representing Centennial, there are great examples of discipline, dedication, and passion. In just less than 2 months, through a lot of hard work, they managed to go from the last team in the league to beating the first place team in the semifinals and ending in second place. They put in their blood, sweat, and tears and have made us all very proud. The most improved player goes to Miguel Shahal. The MVP, Mr. Setter, Sebastian Martinez de Vigo. Thank you. Beach volleyball, coached by Alex Bergeron. Promising to never let Centennial down, these four teams showed up on the beach courts early in the morning and gave it their all. Through rainy weather and strong opponents, they really powered through and came out on top, with our junior team winning first place in the RSEQ tournament and senior team making it to quarterfinals. They played their hearts out and could not have represented the Centennial Charger spirit and work ethic any better. Congratulations to you all. Co-MVPs, Sebastian Martinez and Alexi Tam.
Thank you. Bantam Girls Flag Football, coached by Ms. Chartrand, Ms. Heron, and Ms. Rosenoff. Wow. In their first year playing flag football, this group has been very impressive. With every practice and game, they have developed and improved, which has led them to an undefeated regular season of 6-0, scoring 167 points with only 13 points scored against them. It has been a pleasure coaching these girls, and we're all very excited to see what they will go on to do over the next 4 years. Thank you also to Michelle Nang for helping out. Good luck at the RACQ Regionals this Sunday. The MIP goes to Megan Rogers. MVP, Mally Jolie. Good luck this weekend. Bantam Boys Flag Football, coached by Mr. Dobbs and Mr. Dan. Hat off. Quiet, please. It was an absolute pleasure coaching this group of young boys. Although the team did not have any real experience playing flag football, they worked hard, came out strong, and surprised everyone, going 3-1 in our first two tournaments. For the last tournament, we knew it was going to be difficult, as we had some key players missing. The players fought hard, but unfortunately, we just missed going to regionals. Although the season did not end how we wanted, we're all still very proud of this group of young individuals and look forward to seeing what their potential brings in our flag football program in the years to come. Enjoy the summer and see you on the field next year. The co-MVPs are Nicholas Desha and William Inthule.
Junior girls flag football, coached by myself and Miss Rosenoff. With very few girls having played flag before, they had to learn the game quickly, and they did just that. They have improved over the season and continue to develop their individual skills and team play. They have finished second in their section and will be playing in the quarterfinals this Friday in hopes of making it to the regionals on Sunday. Good luck. We are confident they will make it. Co-MVPs are Alea Mergie, yeah, and Benny DeJunga. Junior boys flag football, coached by Mr. Martin. As the boys just came off long volleyball and basketball seasons, our flag season started off in a last minute rush. None of the players had ever played high school flag, so to go from a wild first game at JDLM after just two tryouts without mouth guards and kids wearing inside out shorts, to that same JDLM coach personally coming to speak to me about how much the team had improved just some short 3 weeks later was great to see. If the boys' last game was any indication of what they are capable of, De Rocher will be in big trouble at this weekend's regionals. Congratulations on a fun short season and good luck on Saturday. Playing solid defense and stepping up to make some big plays on offense, the most improved player goes to Zachary Turbine. Playing solid on both sides of the field and giving everything he had to help turn this team around, the MVP goes to Kimmy Fontaine. Kimmy, you could smile, eh? Still not smiling. Senior girls flag football. Coaches Miss Mimo and Mr. Seb Gobby. Watching this group of girls go from learning the game of flag football in secondary one to becoming the athletes they are now in secondary five is truly remarkable. These girls created such a strong bond that no team could beat. They were able to laugh on the sidelines while working hard on the field. Congrats, girls, and good luck to all of our seniors graduating this year. The MIP goes to Sophia Lacerano. Co-MVPs are Megan Butler and Zoe Ann Bajoka. Senior boys flag football, coached by Mr. Chesney and Mr. Dalzell. It was nice having flag back in Centennial this year, but the two-year layoff and condensed schedule brought some challenging for the juvenile boys early in the season. Please stop talking. Their 1-5 record was not indicative of the talent of this team displayed on the field, especially during a spirited 30-21 loss to undefeated Trinité, a team that no one had come close to matching up with all year, and during a game against CCL where the offense and special team exploded for 48 points. Although it was a frustrating season overall, the secondary five boys on the team went out as winners in our final game as a Centennial Charger athlete. And that is something they'll hopefully remember when looking back on their athletic careers. The most valuable player goes to Vito Novielli. Track and field, coached by Miss Dunn, Miss Rain, Mr. G, Mr. Martin, Mr. Dobbs. Bantam track and field. This team consisted of 12 boys and 8 girls. At the SSIA meet, the boys won 3 gold, 5 silver, and 8 bronze medals and placed first for their category. The girls won 5 gold, 3 silver, and 3 bronze medals and placed third for their category. MVPs go to Alec Chatterjee, Liam Illick, and Emma Lee. Thank you, Bantam. Junior track and field. This team consisted of 22 boys and 12 girls. At the SSIA meet, the boys won 1 gold, 6 silver, and 5 bronze medals and placed second for their category. The girls won 1 gold, 2 silver, and 3 bronze medals and placed fourth in their category. MVPs go to Nicholas Alendrekos. Walk towards. Go walk down, Alex. Nicholas, go walk down a bit. And Amber Picado. Yes, you could go now. Thank you, Shimo, for all your help. Senior track and fields. Holy moly. All the way down. This team consisted of 27 boys and 25 girls. At the SSIA meets, the boys won 6 gold, 5 silver, and 3 bronze medals and placed second for their category. The girls won 1 gold, 2 silver, and 1 bronze, and placed third for their category. Move down.
Win the wings.
Move down. We have 4 MVP winners. The first MVP goes to Waleed Badran. Second MVP, Loic Morin. Third MVP, Natalia Jelowicki Fanvan. Natalia's over there. 3 MVP winners. Congratulations.
It's embarrassing.
Charger Merit Awards. Charger Merit Awards. These awards will be presented to a select group of student athletes. They have impressed their Charger coaches in one or more of the following ways. One, through dedication to their sport, team, and our interscholastics program. Two, by exemplifying the role of a student athlete. Three, by acting as a role model to other Charger athletes. And four, by being described as an athlete that any coach would want on their team. I would ask that our vice principals, Mr. Poirier and Ms. Prokosh, please come up on the stage to hand these awards out. Tonight we will honor 14 merit award winners, and as your name is called, please come up and remain on the stage until everyone has been called upon. Our first merit award winner goes to Rebecca Chan. Next, we have Sarah Yamasaki. Sebastian Martinez Davila. Megan Francard. Loic Morin. Caitlin Hewitt. Zachary Rahal. Tatiana Conanier. Theodore D'Alessio. Camilla Gittins. Amelia Nolasco-Brochu. Jonathan Grew. Vito Novielli. And last but not least, Adrian Delier. Thank you and congratulations. Oh, sorry, two more. Take your time, it's okay. Thank you and congratulations. Next, we will recognize our grade 7 students who in their first year here at CRHS have impressed all of their coaches and everyone that has seen them in action. They have been a part of many teams and have won awards already here tonight. The potential they all possess has us all very excited to see what they will accomplish in the next 4 years. The most promising female athlete award goes to Emma Lee. And Isabella Montescleros. Congratulations. and Megan Rogers. The most promising male athletes, and we have three as well. The first one goes to Nicholas Dobbs. Next, we have Liam Illick. And finally, Alec Chatterjee.
Junior and Senior Athletes of the Year. These plaques are the highest interscholastic athletic awards presented. Junior candidates are selected from secondary three classes. Senior candidates are selected from the graduating class, but the total of their centennial sports contribution, highlighted by their senior year, is considered. Selected criterion. These candidates have first distinguished themselves by making a major contribution in one sport and also playing a significant role in one or more other sports. They display a positive attitude, both as a leader for their teammates and in their relationships with their coaches. Their dedication and commitment to practice and play in their chosen sport so as to obtain the maximum from their natural talents. And finally, by exemplifying a true student athlete in that they maintained a high academic standing, thereby maintaining a balance between their academic and athletics. We would like to call upon our principal, Sherry Tite. Junior Female Athletes of the Year. In just the short time that these young athletes have been here at Centennial, they have both made a big impression on their coaches, teammates, and all of those that have had the opportunity to see them in action. Our first recipient is a natural leader. Not only is she extremely talented, but she puts in the extra work to improve. Her determination to succeed is a pleasure to see and coach, not only on the playing field, but also in the classroom as well. Simply put, she gets it. As a student in TAG Liberal Arts, she has maintained a high academic standing with an overall average of above 85% for these past 3 years. As a grade 9 student, she played an important role as point guard for the senior girls basketball team, scoring the winning basket in an amazing comeback to get the bronze medal at the RSEQ Regionals. Along with basketball, this student played volleyball and was the quarterback for the junior girls flag football team that will be playing Friday in the quarterfinals. She does anything she needs for her and her team to succeed. She also plays competitive basketball outside of school and hopes to get a scholarship one day. Our co-recipient is a natural athlete that is always willing to put extra work to improve. Her determination to perform and improve her skills is what makes her a special athlete. After missing out on a few years of sports at CRHS, she participated in as many sports as possible this year. Whether it be field hockey, badminton, volleyball, or flag football, this athlete improved nonstop throughout her seasons because she always found a way to practice on her own time to better herself. As a competitive figure skater, she would leave her early morning practices in a hurry to make it to 8 a.m. practice for her centennial teams. Even after two morning practices in the same day, this student athlete in our Francais program still finds a way to get an 85% overall average. Her dedication and passion are like no other. She's a great example of a student athlete and a centennial charger. We all look forward to seeing what these two outstanding girls will accomplish in their last 2 years here at CRHS and beyond. Congratulations to both our recipients. This year's co-junior female athletes are Alina Chopra Anaïs Samanez-Denis. Stay on stage, okay? Junior male athletes. In just their first year having interscholastic sports to be a part of, these young athletes have already stood out, having made big impressions on their coaches, teammates, and spectators that have gone to see them play. Our first recipient is a natural leader, talented, and he puts in the extra work to improve. This recipient played volleyball, basketball, and flag football. Through hard work and dedication, he has had a positive impact on and off the court. His commitment to our school team goes beyond just playing. He was also always willing to help set up gyms and scorekeep for other Centennial teams. From bus rides to long waits between games, he always found a way to bring the team together. We cannot wait to see where his leadership will take him. Our second recipient, although quiet, continues to put in the hard work necessary to improve and become better at his main sport of basketball, where he has already won MIP here tonight. He also played an important role on the junior boys flag football team, where his kicking skills helped the team out. Our third recipient has unbelievable athletic ability that can be witnessed as soon as he steps on the court and fields. His speed is unguardable. He plays basketball both at CRHS, where he was named the MVP tonight, and city football as well, where he remains as one of the top players. This athlete will no doubt continue to learn, grow, and develop his skills, where we as coaches know that the sky's the limit for this young athlete. All of our junior male athletes possess a determination to succeed, and we can't wait to see what they will accomplish in the next couple of years. Congratulations to our three junior male athletes of the year, Ashton Enfield. Logan Bélanger-Holman. Caden Dewey Hall.
You're moving pretty slowly for someone who's so fast.
You gotta keep it under control.
Congratulations to our junior athletes of the year. Senior female athletes. This year's Senior Athlete of the Year has had an impact on the Centennial Athletics program as soon as she ran into the gyms. She is a phenomenal athlete with incredible natural athletic ability. As a member of multiple teams, this athlete, although quiet, has played an important role on the field hockey, cross country, basketball, volleyball, track and field, and flag football teams every year she has played. Over the years, she has won numerous medals and both MIP and MVP awards, including one here tonight. This athlete was also named the most promising athlete in Secondary 1 and Junior Female Athlete of the Year in Secondary 3. She will be attending Champlain this fall in the Pure and Applied Science program, where she will continue her studies to become an engineer. Right there with her at Champlain will be our co-senior athlete winner of the year, where she will be studying in the health science program. This co-female senior athlete of the year's hard work and determination has also paid off. She has proven to be a natural leader as team captain for many of her teams and has also been awarded team MVPs in field hockey, basketball, and flag football here tonight. Taking time to give back, this athlete also coached some of our junior teams and has reffed the tournaments as well. Despite having very busy schedules, academics do come first, and both student athletes have managed to maintain an 85% average this year and have been on the principal's honor roll every year since secondary one. Exemplifying what a student athlete should be, proving that their work in the classroom was just as important as on the playing field. Both girls have been awarded with many athletic and academic awards. Two very intelligent, high-skilled athletes, they both have been integral parts of the success of all of their teams in and outside of school. Their active role not only with their play, but also with their involvement of coaching and mentoring of younger students is extraordinary. They are both well-rounded and determined to succeed at everything they do. They have and will continue to make their coaches, parents, and all those around them extremely proud. Excellent job, girls. Thank you. The 2022 Co-Senior Female Athletes of the Year are Natalia Jelowicki Fanfan, and Megan Butler. Senior male athlete. This student athlete has been a great asset to Chargers Athletics over his time here at Centennial. This athlete's goofy personality has made him stand out as a leader and has created good vibes on any team he was on. This student is very well liked by his coaches, his teachers, and his peers. He brings up team spirit in sports and brings up the morale in the class. This student athlete began his high school years by participating in various sports from soccer to hockey. He was a keen student athlete, even trying to come to intramurals on senior days. His coaches all commended his improvement throughout middle school. Although the pandemic has stopped sports for most of his senior year here at CRHS, that didn't stop him from receiving the award for junior athlete in secondary three. As sports came back in his last year here at CRHS, he joined several teams as well, participating in soccer, hockey, flag football, and track and field. He demonstrated his passion for sports. He also played hockey for his community, where he helped his team win in playoffs. He has developed a strong work ethic and determination to achieve these accomplishments. While noting many of his athletic achievements, it is important to note his academic accomplishments as well. This athlete was able to exemplify what it means to be a student athlete by putting studies first. He achieved an average of 87% in term one, while also balancing a hectic athletics schedule. Although this student possesses a great deal of natural talent, it was hard work and dedication that led him to where he is. We wish him all the best next year at Champlain Lennoxville. Congratulations to the recipient of our highest award, Dante Troji. Congratulations to our Senior Athletes of the Year.
I just want to say thank you to all our coaches, because without our coaches, we wouldn't have had all these wonderful teams brought back and all the life brought back into our school. So coaches from the administration, from all our athletes, Parents, thank you very much for all the extra time you do. We really appreciate it.
That's it for Sports Awards 2022. Thank you, everybody.